Cryptography is terrifying. It's based on math that most of us don't understand, yet is the one thing that makes the internet secure. Without the mysterious art of cryptography, there would be no secrets and no privacy in the digital world. Your emails, bank records, and browsing history would be easily hackable. Computers, by design, do exactly what we tell them to do. But sometimes we don't want them to do certain things, like expose private data.
I'm sorry, Dave. I'm afraid I can't do that.
Cryptography can take some useful bytes of data, then scramble them up with an algorithm, making it nearly impossible for a computer to understand its true meaning without the proper credentials. In today's video, we'll look at 7 useful crypto concepts that every developer should know. And the best way to learn this stuff is to get hands-on, so we'll implement each concept in Node.js with its built-in crypto module. And make sure to stay tuned until the end, because there's a challenge, and the first person to solve it gets a free lifetime pro membership and t-shirt. Cryptography is the science of creating secrets, and has been around long before the computer. Before humans got good at math, they would tattoo secrets on the shaved head of a slave, then let their hair grow out to obfuscate it. But there are some obvious vulnerabilities with this pattern. An attacker could simply shave the head to access the message. Things got much better by the time of Julius Caesar, who shifted the letters of the alphabet before passing messages to his military generals, creating what's known as the Caesar cipher. Now fast forward to 2025, and all the algorithms you're using today are made obsolete by super mega quantum computers that can crack them with brute force. The point I'm making is that cryptography is always evolving. What is considered safe and secure today may not be the case tomorrow. Luckily, as a developer, you don't need to understand all the complex math that goes into cryptography, but it is absolutely essential to understand how certain key concepts work, like hashing, encryption, and signing, just to name a few. The first concept we'll look at is the hash. What is a hash? The name sounds kind of intimidating to me, but the word itself actually has culinary roots, meaning to chop and mix, and that perfectly describes what a hashing function does. You start with an input, which can be any length, then pass it off to a hashing function. This function returns a fixed length value of what looks like just meaningless garbage. The important thing here is that the function will always produce the same output given the same input. It needs to be fast to compute and unique. However, it's extremely difficult for a computer to reverse engineer what the original message actually was. These are really useful characteristics because it allows developers to store data without needing to know its true value. The most simple example would be storing a password in the database. You wouldn't want to store the real password, because if a hacker gets a hold of that database, then they can immediately start putting those passwords to use. But if the data is hashed, then they have to also crack that hash to figure out what the true password is. Let's go ahead and implement a hash in Node.js. You can follow along with the source code on Fireship.io or GitHub, and all you need to get started is a JavaScript file with Node.js installed on your system. The first thing we'll do is import the createHash function from Node Crypto, which is a module built into Node.js. What I'll do next is define my own custom function called hash that takes a string as an input and returns a hash string as the output. The first step is to define the hashing algorithm that you want to use. I'm using SHA-256 here, which stands for Secure Hashing Algorithm, and returns a hash value, which is also called a digest, with 256 bits. The algorithm you choose here is important. In my last video, I carelessly used MD5 when hashing an API key, and you guys were quick to call me out on it. As computers have become faster and the internet more vast, MD5 has become obsolete. Remember, cryptography is always evolving. SHA-256 is a good option, but there are even better solutions like Argon2, although it's not built into Node Crypto. Once we have our hashing function, we can call update with the input value and then return an output by calling digest with the format that we want to return. In this video, we'll be using hexadecimal format, but another option you'll commonly see is base64. Now that we have this function, we can pass it an input like a password, and when you console it, you get this long string of numbers and letters that hide its original meaning. Now if we create another hash and compare the two, we'll know that the original value is the same if the two hashes match up. That's super useful, but a hash by itself isn't actually sufficient for storing a password in a database. And that brings us to our next topic, salt. The fact that a hashing function always returns the same value is also a problem when it comes to passwords, especially when you let stupid humans come up with them, like password 123.
So the combination is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's the stupidest combination I ever heard in my life!
If a hacker obtains the database and the passwords are hashed, they can often just go to something like a rainbow table that has a bunch of pre-computed hashes and find a bunch of commonly used passwords. A salt is just a random value that's added to the password before it's hashed, therefore making it much harder to guess. In Node, we can hash a password with salt by importing scrypt and the random bytes function. Then we'll define functions, signup and login, that take an email and password as their arguments. When the user signs up, we'll generate a salt, which is just a random set of characters. Then we'll use scrypt to hash it. We provide it with the original password and salt, and provide a key length, which is recommended to be 64. Without going into details, scrypt makes it more computationally intensive to crack with brute force, and it's actually been used as a proof of work algorithm used in cryptocurrency mining. So now that we have a hash password, we also need to store the salt with it in the database, and we can do that by just prepending it to the existing string separated by a semicolon. Now when the user goes to log in, we can grab the salt from the database and recreate the original hash. Now we could just compare the strings here, but as one added touch, I'm going to use the timing safe equal function from Node Crypto, which can prevent timing attacks, where a hacker measures the amount of time it takes to perform an operation to obtain information about the value. This function helps prevent that type of attack. That's how basic email password authentication works on the web. But a related topic you might come across is hash-based message authentication code, or HMAC. The quick definition is that it's a hash that also requires a password, so the only person that can create the same hash signature must also have the corresponding password or key. An example is a JSON web token for authentication on the web. When a user logs in on a trusted server, it generates a token with its key, then the client and server can pass it back and forth, and the server can trust it because it knows that only someone with the secret key could have generated that hash signature. In Node, we can import the create HMAC function, then we'll define a secret key along with the message that we want to hash. We can create a hash just like we did in the first example. The only difference is that we also provide this key. The important thing to notice here is that we get the same hash when the same password is used, but if a different password is used, we get an entirely different hash. That's pretty cool, but what happens when you want to share a secret with someone and also allow them to read the original message? That's where encryption comes in. What is encryption exactly? With encryption, we take a message, scramble up the bytes to make it unreadable, that's called the ciphertext, then provide a key or password allowing somebody else to decrypt it. It's also typically randomized so that each time you encrypt, you get an entirely different encrypted output, even if the key and message are the same. The first encryption example we'll look at is symmetric, which means that there is a shared password that both the sender and receiver of the message will need. To implement it in Node, we're going to import create cipher IV. IV stands for initial vector, by the way, along with random bytes, and create decipher. First, we have the message itself, that's what we're trying to encrypt, then we'll define the key as 32 random bytes, and also the initial vector as 16 random bytes. This will randomize the output when it's encrypted, so an identical sequence of text will never produce the exact same ciphertext, making it more difficult for a hacker to break the encryption. Now we can use these values to create a cipher. Like a hash, it's dependent upon an algorithm, although encryption algorithms are inherently different than hashing algorithms, so you'll notice an entirely different set of options here. Now you can use the cipher to encrypt a message by calling update, or even multiple messages if you want to, then finish it off by calling cipher final and add that value to the end of the encrypted message. At this point, the cipher can no longer be used to encrypt data. Now to decipher it, create a decipher object with the same key and initial vector. Use the same basic pattern with update and final to convert the encrypted message back into plain text. And that's how you encrypt and decrypt a message in Node.
The world isn't run by weapons anymore, or energy, or money. It's run by little ones and zeros, little bits of data. It's all just electrons.
However, there is one big limitation with symmetric encryption, and that's the fact that both the sender and receiver of the message need to share a password. It's just not very practical for two different parties to agree upon a shared password. Once again, math comes to the rescue, this time in the form of a public key crypto system. Instead of one key, it uses two keys that are mathematically linked, a public key and a private key. As the name suggests, the private key should always be kept secret, while the public key can be shared with other people. Think of it like a mailbox. You have a slot where anybody can add mail into the box, that's your public key, but to get the mail out, you need the private key, which can only be done by the owner of the key. In Node, we can generate a private and public key pair using the generate key pair function. The first argument is the crypto system you want to use, which in our case will be RSA. That's the most common one that you'll come across. From there, you can define a bunch of settings, like the length of the key in bits, and also the encoding for the public and private key. We'll go with the recommended settings here, and have it return a format of PEM to show us the keys in Base64 format. You can also add a passphrase to your private key for added security. If we go ahead and console log, we get values for the public and private keys. Then I'll export them from this file to put them to use. And that brings us to asymmetric encryption. You use asymmetric encryption anytime you go to a website using HTTPS. The browser will automatically find a public key of an SSL certificate installed on the website. That public key is used to encrypt any data that you send to the website. That prevents hackers from gaining anything useful from it in transit. Your data is then decrypted with the private key by the trusted website. The implementation in Node is very simple. We import public encrypt and private decrypt from Node Crypto, along with the public key and private key that we generated previously. We can then encrypt a message or put it in the mailbox by combining the public key with the message itself. In this case, it needs to be in a buffer format. That will encrypt it so that only the owner of the mailbox can read it. At some point in the future, the recipient may want to read the original message, which can be done by calling private decrypt with the private key and the encrypted data. Encryption is fun, but in many cases you don't actually need to encrypt data, but rather validate that it came from a trusted party. That's where signing comes in. What is a digital signature? Let's imagine you're expecting a letter in the mail with some sensitive information. You need to be able to trust that that letter came from the right person, so you require them to sign it in blood. It also can't be tampered with, so they put a special seal on it that, if broken, will indicate that it's been tampered with. Digital signatures work in the same basic way. The sender of the message will use their private key to sign a hash of the original message. The private key guarantees authenticity, like blood, and the hash guarantees that the message can't be tampered with because it would produce an entirely different signature. The recipient can then use the public key to validate the authenticity of the message. In Node, we can create a signature with the createSign function, then pass it an algorithm that uses the RSA crypto system with SHA-256 for hashing. We then update it with the message that we want to sign and create the actual signature with the private key. We can now attach the signature to the original message and send it to someone. When they get it, they can create a verifier, update the original message, and then verify the signature with the sender's public key. If the signature was forged or the message changed, the verifier will fail. And that gives us 7 different cryptography concepts that I think every developer should know. The final thing I'll leave you with is a challenge. In the GitHub repo, there's a file called hack.js. Inside it is a hash. Use your hacking skills to crack it and put the answer below. First one to submit a pull request wins a free lifetime pro membership and t-shirt. If this video helped you, hit the like button and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.